Hello, everyone. Welcome to Morning English. This is Colin.
Hello, everybody. This is Summer. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
I just read something interesting this morning.
Yeah, what is it?
A celebrity is being sued because she put a paparazzi photo of herself on Instagram.
What? Really? 就是明星啊被狗仔偷拍了。然后自己拿了这张照片发在 Ins 上，不过反过来被狗仔来起诉了。那我不知道这个狗仔起诉的原因是什么呢？ What are they suing for?
The copyright of the photo. They say the celebrity profited from the photo as there's ads on her Instagram to promote her music. But she posted without permission. So they are seeking
$150,000
American damages.
Wow. 所以狗仔起诉这个明星的理由是他们自己才拥有照片的版权 the copyright of the photo. 那么明星在这个 Ins 上发照片呢是能赚钱的。不过 she posted without permission, 未经许可就发了照片所以狗仔要他赔钱。
You know, she's not the first star to be sued for sharing paparazzi images of themselves to social media. Gigi Hadid and Justin Bieber have also faced similar cases.
Oh, 所以这个还不是个例啊。明星被偷拍了，但是偷拍的照片自己还发不了。然后这种被偷拍的啊，狗仔拍的照片啊，不知道刚刚大家听出来没有，就是用这个词啊 paparazzi image.Or paparazzi photo.
Right. I guess many people know this word because of a song from Lady Gaga. Papa paparazzi.
Yeah. Paparazzi, right?
Yeah.
对几年前很火的一首歌啊 Paparazzi. 狗仔。但其实这个狗仔这个单词啊是个意大利词语对吧 Colin? It's an Italian word.
Yeah, that's right.
How would you say that?
Paparazzi.
Uh-huh.
Like a lot of people might say paparazzi.
对
But paparazzi.
一听就很好啊就意大利风味对吧 Paparazzi. 或者呢美式英语中的读法呢就是 paparazzi. Paparazzi.、
Mm.
OK, 那我们刚刚讲到这个话题呢我觉得其实明星他也有肖像权嘛那他们是不是可以反过来告狗仔侵害他们的肖像权哎 Colin, 这个英文怎么说The right of image?
Well, here we say the right of publicity. It's the right of an individual to control the commercial use of one's identity, such as their name, image, or likeness.
Okay, 所以这个肖像权呢，通常英文表达是 the right of publicity. So celebrities also have the right of publicity, right? They can also sue the paparazzi.
Well, the relationships between celebrities and paparazzi can be complicated. Sometimes the paparazzi photos can help boost the star's popularity.
Okay, 也是啊，明星因为身份特殊嘛，肖像权的限制可能更多。但是呢，对于普通人来说呢，我觉得肖像权还是很重要的。正好我最近还看了一些还比较可怕的新闻。就是说女生被偷拍偷拍软件啊各种偷拍的产业链什么的那他们的肖像权就是被严重侵害了
You mean like the hidden cameras in a hotel?
Yeah, right, just like that 像是酒店里的隐藏摄像头啊鞋子上的摄像头啊偷拍软件各种
Okay, well, let's talk about that today
Hello, welcome to Morning English早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道每天都会更新如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容我们都会在这个频道更新我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语如果你觉得还不错的话记得给我们订阅哦另外点开小铃铛这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦对了如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记在视频简介或者评论区领取哦你也可以给这个视频点赞点赞就相当于自动保存啦
首先呢是有个这种细思恐极的 app 它名字叫做安全相机 So what do you think of the name of this app? Security camera
Security camera Well, I would think the camera must be safe to use Like, it wouldn't give away your location, your personal information, or things like that
Yeah, right, 是吧？这个听上去像是一个保护隐私的相机，但其实这个安全相机啊，一点都不安全。它被很多变态拿来偷拍女生照片，因为它有很多很诡异的功能啊，比如说屏幕是黑的也能照相，自动连拍、月后积分、联网共享照片等等等等。
Oh, these functions sound really creepy.
Yeah, right, creepy. 这个 creepy 就是变态的、怪异的。而且这个软件的评论区啊，很多人的留言也很变态。They leave some very creepy comments, like, I like going out more often. I don't have to worry about my wife checking my photos.
Can people still download this app?
No. 新闻报道之后，这个软件就被下架了。所以你能看出来它真的一点都不安全。It has been taken down from the App Store.
Oh, it's good to know.
Yep. 这个软件就被用来偷拍了。那我们讲到偷拍呀、啊、Colin, how do you say that? To take a photo secretly?
Yeah, that one will do. To take a photo of someone secretly or discreetly. Here we can also use the word discreetly to mean...Being careful in what you do in order to keep something secret.
Mm-hmm. Secretly, 这个词我们知道是偷偷的意思。那还有一个词也可以用 discreetly, 有谨慎的这个意思，对吧？谨慎的做某事，悄悄的做。所以偷拍呢，也可以是 take a photo discreetly.
Now, I know that in the office, you're the one who likes to take photos of others secretly.
我这是出于善意的偷拍啊，留下大家最真实的一面。
And we can also use the word sneaky. It means to behave in a secret way. So we say to take a sneaky photo.
Okay, 还有一种表达 take a sneaky photo. Sneaky, 这个词就是偷偷摸摸的。所以可以表示偷拍的意思。但是你看啊，中文的偷拍就很简洁，一个词就搞定了。那英文中有没有也是一个单词可以表示偷拍的？
One word, maybe you mean the word upskirt.
Upskirt, what does that mean?
Skirt, you know, a kind of dress that women wear. So...Upskirt means a video or photo that has been taken with the camera aimed up a woman's skirt, often secretly without her consent.
Oh, this is disgusting. 这个词确实很简洁啊，但是行为太恶心了。这个词是由两个部分组成的 up, 向上的 skirt, 裙子。所以 upskirt 就是从裙子里向上拍的照片。指裙底偷拍的照片或者是视频。People who take the upskirt photos are really disgusting.
Yeah, yeah. And we should make sure that the men responsible for this disgusting upskirt video is sued. In this way, we can prevent this kind of thing from happening again.
对，这种偷拍啊，犯罪成本其实很低。一是受害者自己都发现不了，二是呢，发现之后他们也可以狡辩。然后我看很多报道啊，其实这种偷拍在公众场合啊，比如地铁、公交，经常发生，而且背后还有产业链的交易呢。
And another disgusting thing is the hidden camera in the hotels.
Yeah, right. Hidden camera 就是我们刚刚前面提过的隐藏相机。Hide 有躲起来的意思吗？Hidden 就是过去分词，所以 hidden camera 藏起来的相机。这种事其实很多曝光啊，就是酒店里呢会有这种隐藏的相机。
Well, there's another word I would use here, spy cam. That means a spy camera.
Spy camera, spy 就是间谍的那个 spy, 然后可以简写成 spy cam, 也是这种隐藏的相机，对吧？
Right, these hidden cameras or spy cams have raised so much concern nowadays because these devices are cleverly placed in really normal looking stuff.
Yeah, I've heard about that. 这个我也看了，就是这些相机真的很可怕，隐藏的特别到位，像什么烟雾报警器啊，充电器里啊，可能都装着这种相机。
Exactly, such as smoke detectors, alarm clocks,phone chargers, and even shampoo bottles. It would never occur to you to examine these items once you get into the hotel.
没错， 而且在韩国啊，这种偷拍呢更加猖獗。我听说在首尔的公厕里，就是只要有洞的地方，都被女生用纸堵上了。Women in South Korea live in the fear of being taken a photo by the hidden camera.
Yeah, I also read something saying that in South Korea, a crime ring was busted after secretly filming and live streaming the actions of over 1,600 motel guests.
Oh my god, 1600名酒店的客人都被这个秘密拍摄，还被实时直播了。Secretly filming and live streaming. 这个犯罪团伙呢是被抓住了，但说不定呢还有无数个这样的团伙。那这种犯罪团伙啊，就可以说 a crime ring. Ring 就是戒指那个 ring, 但也可以表示一个团伙。比如说贩毒集团就是 a drugs ring.
The technology is getting smaller, and it's become really easy for people to install these micro cameras. So we should be more aware of that.
没错，不管是哪种偷拍，像公众场合拍裙底的、酒店里的秘密摄像头啊，大家都需要提高警惕意识。而且更重要的是，发现这种偷拍之后，要勇敢地大声说出来，要捍卫自己的权益。Never be afraid to speak out against such acts.
Right.
Hello, welcome to Morning English. 早安英文呢是一个为大家免费提供英语教学的频道，每天都会更新。如果你想获得关于英语听说读写的内容，我们都会在这个频道更新。我们的目标是帮助全球的华人学好英语。如果你觉得还不错的话，记得给我们订阅哦。另外，点开小铃铛，这样的话就不会错过其他任何学习视频啦。对了，如果你想获取本节课的完整版笔记，在视频简介或者评论区领取哦。你也可以给这个视频点赞，点赞就相当于自动保存啦。
Okay, I think that's all the time we have for today.
Okay, 那我们今天聊的偷拍这些事儿呢，大家有什么好方法来应对的，也欢迎留言告诉我们。
Thank you so much for listening. This is Colin.
This is Summer. See you next time.
Bye. Bye.